Hi everyone. Today in this video, let us discuss precautions and side effects of aripiprazole. Aripiprazole is one of the well-known drug with the brand name ABILIFY. This drug is one of the atypical antipsychotic, which is effective in many of the psychotic disorders. This drug can be used in the treatment of schizophrenia. This is one type of mental illness which can produce some hallucinations within the patients. So patients may have some auditory and visual hallucinations where the patient can perceive something which is not there. And another symptom is the delusions, where the patients may have wrong perceptions along with some restlessness. All these symptoms are collectively called as schizophrenia. So in such patients, aripiprazole can be given as atypical antipsychotic. So this is the new generation antipsychotic compared with the typical antipsychotics, which is somewhat more effective in relieving both positive as well as negative symptoms of schizophrenia. Apart from this antipsychotic action, this drug can be used in other conditions which are associated with irritability and agitation. For instance, it can be used to treat irritability within the children with autistic disorder, where the children with age 6 to 17 years, aripiprazole can be given to treat the irritability. Similarly, this drug can also reduce the agitation in the patients with any bipolar mania, where the mood swings from mania to depression and depression to mania. Otherwise, the patients who are having the agitation associated with psychotic disorders, in such conditions, aripiprazole can be given to reduce the agitation. Similarly, this drug can also be used in the treatment of Tourette's disease. This is one of the conditions where we can observe some involuntary movements resulting in eye blinking, movement of the shoulders, expression of offensive words, repetitive words. All such conditions are because of involuntary movements, which again controlled by aripiprazole. So today in this video, we are going to see what are the important precautions and side effects of this drug, aripiprazole. First of all, let us see the precautions of this drug. Aripiprazole, just like other antipsychotics, it can produce orthostatic hypotension. So this is the reduction of blood pressure with change in the posture, which is also called as postural hypotension. And this effect of aripiprazole is because of its action on alpha-1 receptors. On the blood vessels, alpha-1 receptors are present, which are responsible for vasoconstriction. Now, aripiprazole can block these alpha-1 receptors, resulting in vasodilatation. So, this vasodilatation reduces the blood pressure, leading to orthostatic hypotension. So, in such patients, we can observe some syncope, falling sensation, dizziness, and even increased heart rate resulting in tachycardia. All these symptoms can be observed because of orthostatic hypotension. So if patient already taking any vasodilators, this aripiprazole should be carefully given. Similarly, this drug can produce some metabolic changes within the patients. Particularly, it can increase the glucose levels, resulting in the hyperglycemia. This is more important in the patients with diabetes, where glycemic control may be failed due to long-term treatment with aripiprazole. So in such patients, glucose level should be closely monitored. Similarly, this drug can also produce some disturbance in the lipid levels. Finally, it can increase the weight, resulting in the weight gain. And these metabolic changes can be observed within 3 to 6 weeks of the treatment. So after 3 weeks, any increase in the glucose levels, lipid levels, and unexpected weight should be closely monitored with use of aripiprazole. Similarly, this drug can produce neuroleptic malignant syndrome. This is common with many of the antipsychotics, where it can produce some hyperthermia, a sudden rise in the body temperature, some muscle rigidity, tachycardia, and confusion can be observed within the patients. Particularly, other drugs which produce neuroleptic malignant syndrome, such as antidepressants, should be carefully combined with this aripiprazole. Next important precaution is in the elders. The elders may suffer with some dementia, loss of memory. In such patients, we can observe some psychotic behavior. So, psychosis may be associated with the dementia within the elders. In such patients, if aripiprazole is used to control the psychosis, It may increase the cerebrovascular complications, which may result in the increased risk of stroke and death in the patients. That's why this drug should be avoided with dementia-associated psychosis. Similarly, this drug can produce some tardive dyskinesia. Dyskinesia is the disturbance in the kinetic movements, and tardive is the slowly developing. So, aripiprazole can produce some slowly developing disturbance in the kinetic movements, which are somewhat irreversible, resulting in the involuntary movements. But this tardive dyskinesia is observed with chronic use of this drug. Particularly dysphagia, difficulty in swallowing can be observed with this tardive dyskinesia. Similarly, this drug can produce some agranulocytosis, resulting in a neutropenia as well as leukopenia, which increase the risk of infections within the patients. What are the side effects? The important side effects mainly include sedation, some tremor, restlessness. All these are the extrapyramidal side effects that can be produced with this aripiprazole. It can also produce some blurred vision, dyspepsia, constipation, and it can produce some dysphagia, difficulty in swallowing, fatigue, myalgia, muscle pains, some increased anxiety, dizziness, somnolence, and it can also precipitate some cough within the patients. So these are the important side effects of this aripiprazole. Along with this, it can also produce some metabolic changes and tardive dyskinesia and neuroleptic malignant syndrome with chronic use of this drug. So that's about the precautions and side effects of aripiprazole, one of the atypical antipsychotic. Particularly, this drug should be avoided in the elders with dementia-associated psychosis, where it can increase the risk of cerebrovascular complications. So that's for today. Hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel. Share this video with your friends. Post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.